Today I've got with me Mr. Arnold J. Rimmer with his yogi drop. And Mr. Kryten's just went away down my top. He's coming out to say hello, boy. He's Kryten. Here's a yogi drop for you. You're not staying out. They're not usually in this room, so it's a bit, not scary, but different for them. Anyway. Way down. He's going to stay out of the way. Let's see if he wants the yogi drop in there, though. Yeah. Yogi drops are good down when you've got somewhere to hide. Yeah. So, shall we get on and see how this goes? This is my first ever attempt of putting makeup on for being filmed. My birthday's today and I'm being taken out. So I thought, well, I may as well put some makeup on. I've already used the Royalty exfoliating mask and the lip exfoliating mask. What I need to put on now is primer. Where have I put my primer? So this is like a clear gel. Oh, it's a new one. Great. I may have to just chew the top of this off. That worked. Sort of. Enough to get enough out anyway for this. Tidy it up later. It's a lovely velvety feel. But it's just a clear gel. Feels like there's nothing there. It doesn't feel like there's anything on there. And my primer. And the eye primer has a tiny little bit of colour on it. You don't need very much. This just helps everything stick in place. Hello. You doing my darling? She's gonna come out for a minute. Please come say hello. I'm ready for the foundation. It's a touch mineral liquid foundation. I use Velour. And this is the brush. And all I have to do is put a couple of drops into the middle there. And just start putting it where you want it to go. I think it takes 3 drops each side of the face. Everybody does this differently, don't they? So I've already been down the street today and had my makeup done. I cut my hair purple this time instead of pink. I'm going to be very, very tired the rest of the week. I have still to go up to see my mum and father-in-law. It's also my wedding anniversary. My husband proposed to me on my 18th birthday. We got married on my 19th. So we're 27 years today been together. So there. I don't like a thick coverage, I just like a little. And once that's on, I'll do my concealer. And for concealer, when you're using a blending bud, you don't want to use a dry blending bud. Use a wet blending bud. People don't normally put the concealer on the tops, but I have very bad dark circles around my eyes, so I prefer to have the concealer around there. The concealer is a shade lighter than your foundation shade. So what are you going by? I think I added too much of that. I don't do my makeup very often. Not full makeup anyway. I used to do it a lot more before I got ill. This is actually why I decided to do Unique now. Is to try and get back into the things that I used to enjoy. I have very red spots there on each cheek. I always like to give them a bit of coverage. So we're done with the base. We have a plain base to work from now. Now I don't have the Unique set powder, but I have the Effect one. And this is a rice based powder. It's actually really good. This just sets it. Boy's not coming out. You're quite happy down there where you are. Little rat playground down my top. Hello. You coming out? Hello. Is it too early in the day for you? Too early, too bright. Too early, too bright. I know how he feels. Yeah. Now I dry on my eyebrows. I only have half an eyebrow. With thyroid issues, your back end of your eyebrow can get very sparse. And mine's are very sparse. So I have to draw an eyebrow on when I want one. What I like about the Unique pencil is it's so fine, you can basically microblade it. Good thing to remember about your brows is they both don't have to be perfect. They're not meant to be twins. What do you pair doing to each other? Better than I had anyway. At least it looks half an eyebrow now. Actually, that would have been good to do to begin with. So the base for my eyeshadow today is the Splurge shade Happy. I haven't used this before. It's a lovely matte grey. So I've never used the Splurge this cream shadows before, so this is completely new for me. Hooded eye, I have to put my makeup up quite high here, otherwise it just doesn't be seen. If I don't put anything higher than there, it just disappears down behind the hood. That blends really nicely just with your fingertip. I'm actually really impressed with that. Yeah, I'm 47 today. Married 47, 46 today. Married 27 years. Hell, time passes quick enough without me adding on extra years. Don't need to be doing that. I'm a bit on the bottom of my eyes. Eyelids. I'm definitely no expert at doing this, that's for sure. But I'm hoping I'll get better. And it's definitely a lot of fun. So that's the Splurge. I'm sorry, what did I skip you? These are the palette of the powder ones I have so far. I'm going to use. Now I'll go off the silver. I'm not looking for a dramatic look today. And that was the door going, that sounds like my husband's heart nurse is here. Spot of purple in the outer corners just to go with my hair, because why not? He was missing. I didn't want to go for a dramatic eye, but if you can be dramatic, why not? Well, what do you think? Hope they match. Hello, Rimsy. Now this is a white liner. This is brilliant for putting on the, just the very edge of your eye. You do a little V. This will open up your eye. I've got quite small eyes. So the more light you make this corner, the better. And then I do my lash line of white. The waterline, I mean, sorry, not the lash line, I do the waterline of white. This is a dip and draw liner. It can be difficult using these when you've got older eyes. Just for the skin's a little bit more crepe paper-like. There's more lines for the liquid to spread into. I prefer a very thin line in the inner, going to a thicker on the edge. Again, it's just something that opens the eye up more. And here, put it on my under eye. I must have got it on my lashes. You boys having fun down there? Normally these guys would just be sitting up on my shoulders. Better to put a little bit on at a time, because it's a lot easier to put on extra than it is to take it away. So, next is my Epic mascara, and I choose the waterproof one. I just find it stays on better. I have oily skin, and it tends to mean that anything in my eyes transfers off underneath them after a little while. Some people only do it from the bottom up. I feel if you do it that way, then you end up with parts of the lash that's not coated. Been using the lash serum, and it's definitely made my lash grow. I used to have very, very short, stubby lashes, and I've been using the lash serum for probably only about 2 weeks, and what a difference it's made. Very good for you to poke your eyeball. Ow! And again, clever. Oh yeah, bugger. I wonder if everything's just going to go to hell on this side now because my eye's going to run constantly. Hopefully not. Oh dear. Not my day. Always have a wet cloth. Here we go. When you get little dark bits that have dried on underneath, don't try and smudge them, pinch it off. If you just pinch it a little, it comes away a lot better. Oh, babies. You paired it on. And now it brings covered in foundation. It's not going to sparkle much if it's covered in foundation. Come on, guys. So I'll add a little bit of bronzer. I usually quit out, sometimes I have some pink here, but I'm pink enough there today. I didn't sleep very well last night. I always seem to get a red face when I'm tired. So you're just putting this under your cheekbones. Now, I don't know if you can see that, but the foundation doesn't look smooth there, it looks speckly. That's because the dry skin I have, I obviously when I used the exfoliator, I didn't exfoliate that area properly, and that's where it sticks to the dry skin. Brought through my eyeliner, so I can't do that for you. But I would normally, I will be putting on, but I normally have a little black eyeliner along my lash line, not in the inner lash, but just on the outside. And what colour lipstick will it be? So I've got Sensual. Oops. Sensual and Spontaneous, which are two quite different purples, and I think I'll go with this one, which is Spontaneous. It's okay. Mm-hmm. In my handbag, in the front bit, asking a man to go into a woman's handbag. Here we go. there'll be black eyeliner, a little black eyeliner.
Right, pencil.
In the very front, little pouch pockets. We'll see what happens. Here, don't nudge my arm, but I'm doing this. Okay, that's it. Boys. Wow, that's darker than I thought it would be. That's it.
Yeah.
Well done. I normally get my handbag presented to me when I ask for anything out for my handbag. Wow, this is a strong colour. It's a lovely creamy velvety formula. Stop bumping me. What are you doing? I like it though. Nose ring back in. And now I can do my black eyeliner. Well, as I say, I just put it along the lashes rather than inside on the lash line. I normally go for a very pale pink lip, so this is very different for me. And another tip is when you're doing your top eyelashes is to tight line. Tight lining is just the bottom waterline that you have, so it's just taking the pencil going along your top waterline. Little getting used to.